important theorems, no? Very important theorems. First one is called parallaxis theorem, and the next one is called as perpendicular axis theorem. Okay, so listen carefully. So this is a body, ma, and center of mass of the body is somewhere here. For any body, for any body, center of mass position will be there, no? So consider for this body, center of mass is somewhere here. Are you able to understand? Now about this axis, what is this rod you are placing here? This is the axis of rotation. It means around this axis, this body is rotating. Are you able to understand, ma? So moment of inertia about the center of mass, I can write it as ICM, I center of mass, okay? Now what I want to calculate is, I don't want moment of inertia about this axis. I want moment of inertia about another axis, which is parallel to the first axis. Already we studied that moment of inertia depends on axis of rotation, no? If axis of rotation changes, moment of inertia also will change. For example, if you take a disc, clear, no? About the central axis, moment of inertia will be different. Same axis if you place here, then its moment of inertia will be different. So moment of inertia always depends on axis of rotation. Clear, no? Now this is my first axis, ma, which is passing through the center of mass. Now I want to calculate moment of inertia about another axis. So this second axis is like this. Are you able to understand? And moment of inertia about this axis is, I will call it as I. And how these two axes, they are present, they are parallel to each other. If this is the first axis, this is my second axis. Both axes, they are parallel to each other. Clear, ma? So here I will write down, axes are parallel to each other. Okay. And separated by how much distance? And separated by d distance, d distance, okay, ma? So it means, what is the distance between these two axes? Distance between these two axes is d. Are you able to understand? Then parallel axis theorem can be written as I is equals to I center of mass plus md square, where m is total mass of the body. Are you able to understand, ma? So what is the equation of parallel axis theorem? I is equals to I center of mass plus md square. That is the equation for moment of inertia. Are you able to understand, ma? What is I center of mass? This is the moment of inertia when axis is passing through the center of mass. Okay, ma? And this is another axis. But how these two axes, they are arranged? They are parallel to each other and they are separated by a distance of d. Understood, no? Then the equation is I, moment of inertia about this axis is moment of inertia of this axis plus md square. M is mass of the total body. D is the distance between two axes. Are you able to understand? Let us write a small example. See, for example, consider this is a disc. Okay? This is a disc. Mass of the disc is M. Radius of the disc is R. Okay? Now, here center of mass of the disc will be present. No? Where center of mass will be present? Exactly at its geometrical center, because this is a regular body, no? For regular bodies, center of mass will be, moment of inertia, center of mass will be at its geometrical center. So this is the axis of rotation. So around this axis, this disc is rotating. So what is its moment of inertia? I can write I is equals to I center of mass. That is the moment of inertia of this disc around this axis. Clear, no? Now, if I want to calculate moment of inertia about this axis, okay, ma? Then its moment of inertia is I, and they are separated by a distance of 1 meter. Clear, ma? Let mass of this disc is 100 kg. Are you able to understand, ma? And total radius of the disc is, let it be 2 meters. Okay? Then calculate I value. This is the question. Come on, try saying. Are you able to understand, ma? So moment of inertia about this axis is ICM. Moment of inertia of this axis is I. I want to calculate I value. So how can I do the calculation? Come on. So what is the formula of moment of inertia according to parallel axis theorem? See, these two axes, they are parallel, no? These two axes, they are parallel to each other. So therefore, use parallel axis theorem. I is equals to I center of mass plus md square. This is what I can write now. Clear, number? So what is the moment of inertia when axis passes through the center of mass? Half mr square. So half mr square plus md square. What is m here? Total mass of the disk only. Again capital M. And what is meant by d here? D means what? D means the distance between the two axes. And let it be d square. Now substitute all the values. So half. What is the mass of the disk ma? 100 kg. What is the radius of the disk? 2 meter, 2 square. Again mass of the disk? 100. Now d means the distance between two axes. Distance between two axes? 1 meter. So 1 square. Clear no? So therefore it is 2 and square will get cancelled. So 200 plus 100. So 300 kg meter square. Okay ma? So that is the moment of inertia. About which axis? About this axis. Understood no? How we are calculating? So first of all you should remember all these values ma. Moment of inertia of different bodies we have studied no? All those formulae first of all you should remember. Then doing these calculations will become very easy. So therefore I is equals to I center of mass plus md square. That is the formula. Where d means what? Distance between the two axes. Fine no? Okay. So after that we study another theorem which is called as perpendicular axis theorem. Okay ma? Very 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 easy concept ma, this one. If question is given on center of mass, if question is given on moment of inertia, very easily you can solve these questions. Okay, if you understand the basics very clear. So second theorem which is called as perpendicular axis theorem. Axis is singular, ma, axis is plural form. Okay, now so here we have to write one note point, ma. This theorem is applied only for laminar bodies. Okay ma? So this theorem is applicable for which bodies ma? This is applicable only for laminar bodies only. What is meant by laminar bodies? Already we discussed no? Laminar bodies means which have only area. Thickness is not there. Length and breadth are there. Thickness will not be there. Paper is an example of a laminar. Clear no? Now let us see what is meant by laminar body ma. See. Consider this is any lamina which we have taken. Okay ma? So thickness is negligible. Thickness is negligible. Are you able to understand? Now see. So you are not listening properly ma, some of the students. Listen very 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 carefully. Okay? See here. So consider this is one axis ma. Okay? Or you can say this is the axis along x axis. Okay ma? This is the axis of rotation along which axis? About x axis. It means this total body is rotating like this. It can rotate like this about this axis. Clear no? Then what is the axis which is perpendicular to x axis and present in the same plane? So that axis will become y axis. No? So this is y axis. Are you able to understand? No? It means about this axis also, this body can rotate like this. About this axis, it will rotate like this. About this axis, it can rotate like this. Are you able to understand? So moment of inertia about x axis, I will call it as Ix, if body is rotating like this. Similarly, moment of inertia about y axis, I will call it as Iy. Okay? And here, this axis and this axis, they are present in the plane of the lamina. ఈ రెండు యాక్సెస్లు ఎక్కడ ఉన్నాయి? లామినా యొక్క ప్లేన్ పైనే ఉన్నాయి. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దిస్ స్లేట్ యూ కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ యాస్ ఎ లామినా నోమా. సో ఫస్ట్ యాక్సెస్ ఈస్ ప్రెజెంట్ లైక్ దిస్. అబౌట్ దిస్ యాక్సెస్ దిస్ లామినా విల్ రొటేట్. సెకండ్ యాక్సెస్ ఈస్ పర్పెండికులర్ టు ద ఫస్ట్ యాక్సెస్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద సెకండ్ యాక్సెస్. సో నౌ సెకండ్ దిస్ బాడీ కెన్ రొటేట్ లైక్ దిస్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? సో ఎక్స్ యాక్సెస్ అండ్ వై యాక్సెస్ దే ఆర్ పర్పెండికులర్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్. And x axis and y axis, both of them, they are present in the plane of the lamina. So therefore I will write both axis are present, where are present in the plane of lamina. Are you able to understand, ma'am? Then I will take one more axis which is perpendicular to the plane of the lamina and passing through the intersection of both these axes. Okay, ma'am? I am taking third axis. Third axis ela undi? How is the third axis, ma'am? Third axis is perpendicular to the plane of this lamina. Okay? Are you able to understand? This is the lamina, no, which we have taken. Now third axis is like this, okay? Now body can rotate like this. Are you able to understand? So that axis I will call it as IZ, Z axis. And moment of inertia about Z axis is IZ. Are you able to understand? So therefore, how can I describe IZ here? IZ can be described as, so Z axis is perpendicular to plane of lamina. It is perpendicular to the plane of the lamina and it always passes through the intersection of x axis and y axis. Clear now? Then perpendicular axis theorem says that IZ is equals to IX plus IY. That's all. This theorem is called as perpendicular axis theorem. That's all. Very simple. Are able to understand, ma? So x axis and y axis, they are present in the plane of the lamina. Z axis is perpendicular to the plane of the lamina. Then what is the relation between them? IZ is equals to IX plus IY. That is the relation. Are you able to understand, ma? Okay. Now I will give you one question. Try to answer that question by using this perpendicular axis theorem. Okay? Now see. So consider this is a disk. Okay, ma? Mass of the disk is m, radius of the disk is r. So if an axis is passing like this, okay, ma? So moment of I value I want to find out. That is the question. How this axis is present? Axis is through diameter of disk. Okay, ma? What is the arrangement of this axis, ma? Axis is in the plane of this disk and it is along the diameter of the disk. Understood, ma? So how can you calculate moment of inertia of this one? Yala find out just that. Anybody? IX plus IY? No. Think once again. See, ma. So listen very carefully first of all. See. So I want to calculate moment of inertia about this axis, no? Are you able to understand, ma? So let us try. Let us take this figure. Okay. So let us call moment of inertia about this axis as IX. I will call moment of inertia about this axis to be IX. And which is the axis which is perpendicular to this axis? That axis is Y axis. Z is also perpendicular. But in the same plane, IY will be present, no? Clear? So this is IX, the given axis. And I am taking one more axis, IY. Okay. Now can I say that IX and IY, they are equal? Can I say? Moment of inertia about this axis and moment of inertia about this axis, can I say they are equal? Equal and chapacha chapale. Can you say or not? Edoti chapande chapalem endukada. Why can't we say? See, ma, when this is the axis of rotation, mass of the disk, is it changing? Mass is remaining same. Distribution of mass, is it changing? No. Half of the disk is on one side, half of the disk is on another side. Clear, no? Similarly, if you take this to be our axis of rotation, IY, then here also, mass of the disk, is it changing? No. Distribution of mass, is it changing? Half of the disk is on one side, half of the disk is on another side. So mass is not changing, distribution of mass also not changing. Then why moment of inertia will change? Value of moment of inertia also will not change. So definitely I can say IX and IY both are same. It means if disk rotates like this about this axis, or if disk rotates like this about this axis, moment of inertia remains same. Are you able to understand? Because mass is not changing, distribution of mass also not changing. Are you able to understand, ma? So, moment of inertia depends only on two factors, ma. It depends on mass and distribution of mass. Mass is same, distribution of mass is also same. So, moment of inertia does not change. So, about these two axes, moment of inertia remains to be same. Okay. Now, I will take another axis, Z axis. This is the Z axis. Okay, ma? This axis is IZ. Or if you draw one more figure, if you look from other side, this appears like this. Clear, no, ma? So, let us consider this is IX. Let us consider this is IY. And this becomes our Z axis. Are you able to understand? Clear, no, ma? IX and IY, where they are present on the plane of the disk. But what about IZ? IZ ela undi? Cheppandaya, IZ is perpendicular to the plane of the disk. Alage kada unnadi? IZ is perpendicular to the plane of the disk. Inta dulluga unte atla meeru 10th class unna pass aitara ledha? Cheyi isthe idu varaku mingeyali student ante. ఏలు పెడతా అంటే ఏలు కూడా కక్కుంటా ఉన్నారు మీరు. ఇదేమి స్టూడెంట్ లక్షణం ఇది? ఓకే, నమస్తే. నౌ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ మా దిస్ హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ త్రీ యాక్సెస్, నో టూ యాక్సెస్ దే ఆర్ ప్రెసెంట్ ఇన్ ద ప్లేన్ ఆఫ్ ద లామినా. వన్ యాక్సెస్ ఈస్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ద ప్లేన్ ఆఫ్ ద లామినా. Then which theorem I can use? I can use perpendicular axis theorem, no? What is perpendicular axis theorem? IZ is equals to IX plus IY. This is perpendicular axis theorem, no, ma? Okay. What is the name of this axis? IX, no? So instead of IY also, can I write IX? IY badalu kuda IX raaskovachu kada, because IX and IY they are equal. So therefore I will write IZ is equals to 2IX. Okay. And what is IZ value? IZ value is half mr square, no, for a disk. For a disk, when axis is passing through the central axis, what is the moment of inertia? Half mr square. Yesterday only we have written, no? Clear, no? So therefore, half mr square is equals to 2 into IX. Therefore, what is IX? IX is equals to 1 by 4 mr square. So this is my required answer. That's all. Very simple. Understood, no? So therefore, when disk is rotating about this axis, then what is the moment of inertia I got? 1 by 4 mr square. Is it clear? Which theorem I have used? Perpendicular axis theorem. IZ is equals to IX plus IY. Okay. I will give one more question, will you, sir? Try it. See the parallel axis theorem and perpendicular axis theorem. Then I see, ma, this is a disk. And this is the axis of rotation. I want to calculate moment of inertia about this axis. Okay. How is the disk? Sorry, how is this axis of rotation? This axis is at one end of the disk and it is not perpendicular to the disk. It is parallel to the plane of the disk. Understood, no? So what is the meaning of this one? See, ma, if this is a disk, you have a disk control. Okay. So, if axis is passing like this, this becomes the central axis. So, if axis is here and if disk is rotating like this, so axis is one end of the disk. But axis is not like this, axis is like this. Are you able to understand? Axis is present at one end of the disk. Are you able to understand the difference? Axis is like this. And what is the arrangement of axis? Axis is in the plane of this disk itself. This is the plane of the disk, no? So axis is parallel to the plane of the disk. This is the arrangement. It means around this axis, disk will rotate like this. Are you able to understand? Then how can you do the calculation? Let us see how we can do. See. So first of all, what I will do is, first of all, I will take this disk. Are you able to understand? Let us consider this is IY and let us consider this is IX. And this central axis, I will call it as IZ. Okay, ma'am? So I am taking all the three axes, x axis, y axis and z axis. Then already we have done in the last problem, no, IX and IY, they will be equal. IX value and IY value will be equal. Clear, no? Then according to parallel axis theorem, how I can write Iz is equals to Ix plus Iy, or I can write 2Iy, or I can write 2Ix. 2Iy also I can write, 2Ix also I can write, because Ix and Iy they are same. Clear? No? So first to calculate Iy, let us calculate moment of inertia about this axis. Okay. So Iy value will be how much? Iz divided by 2. That's all. No? What is Iz? Central axis. No? So what is the moment of inertia about central axis? Half mr square. So half mr square divided by 2 is how much? 1 by 4 mr square. This is the moment of inertia about which axis? This axis, Iy. Clear no? Why I am calculating this one? Iy is also present in the plane of this disk only, no? And this given axis is also present in the plane of the disk. Now this axis and this axis, they will become parallel, no? Are you able to understand? First of all, we have calculated about this axis. Now see. So therefore, what we have calculated? We have calculated Iy. Okay? And what is the value of Iy? 1 by 4 mr squared. So Iy is equals to 1 by 4 mr squared. Clear? But I don't want about this axis. I want about this axis. No? What is that axis? This axis. Clear? Understood, no? And moment of inertia about this one, let it be I. How these two axes are arranged, parallel or perpendicular? Parallel. Now you can use the parallel axis theorem. Are you able to understand? So, and this one, it is passing through center of mass also, no? This Iy, it is passing through center of mass also. And what is the distance between these two axes? Distance ento untundi? Radius. Clear, no? So D is equal to capital R. Now what is parallel axis theorem? I is equals to I center of mass plus MD square. This is parallel axis theorem. Adhe kada parallel axis theorem. Clear? No? So I is equals to I center of mass. I center of mass is nothing but Iy, no? Iy. So 1 by 4 mr square plus m. And what is the distance between two axes? R. So mr square. Understood? No? So therefore, 1 by 4 plus 1, 5 by 4. So 5 by 4 mr square. So this is the moment of inertia about this axis. Understood? Arthamainda ela chesamo? So first of all, we used parallel perpendicular axis theorem to get moment of inertia about Iy. Now Iy and this given axis, they are parallel. So then again, we have used perpendicular axis theorem. Is it clear? So both theorems we have used, parallel axis as well as perpendicular axis. And one axis and second axis, they are passing on the plane of the lamina. How we got this lamina? By placing rods one above the other, no? Clear, no? So this was one rod, and above that one we have placed one more rod, one more rod, one more rod. Then finally it converted into a lamina. So to calculate moment of inertia, which length we have to use? Perpendicular length to axis. Clear, no? So that is, if I take it as x-axis, okay, then Ix will be how much? It is m L square divided by 12. That's all, no? Why we are taking L here? Because this is the length which is perpendicular to the length of the axis. Okay. Similarly, Iy, m b square divided by 12. Because this is the axis which is perpendicular to the plane of this lamina. Understood, no? Now if I want to calculate moment of inertia about this axis, which axis? This is Z axis. Then what can I do? It means axis is like this. Axis is perpendicular to the plane of this board. Then which theorem I can use? Perpendicular axis I can use, no? So Iz is equals to Ix plus Iy. Okay, ma? What is Ix? So it is ml square by 12. What is Iy? Mb square divided by 12. Clear, no? So therefore, if you take m by 12 common, then it is L square plus B square. So this is the moment of inertia about Z axis. Understood, no? It means, for example, if this is the lamina, are you able to understand, ma? Axis is passing like this. This is the Z axis. Then what is the moment of inertia of Z axis? This one, m by 12 into L square plus B square. By using this theorem, we have done this one. Perpendicular axis theorem. Are you able to understand? Okay. Now Seema. So we write one case here. Case is that if lamina is a square, if lamina is a square, what is meant by lamina is a square? Lamina is a square means length and breadth they are equal. Length and breadth, if they are equal, then it will become a square lamina. No? Now this is a rectangular shaped lamina. Length and breadth are not equal. Okay. If length and breadth are equal, then how can I change this equation? So L is equals to B is equals to A. I can write like this. No? Length and breadth, they are equal, and it is equal to A, where side of the lamina is A. Now substitute here. Same equation. How can you modify? Iz is equals to m by 12 into a square plus a square. Okay, ma? So it is m a square divided by 6. So this is the equation for moment of inertia of a, what? Moment of inertia of a square lamina. About which axis? Axis is passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane of the lamina. Z axis ela undi chudandi? Lamina ki perpendicular ga undi kada? So about that axis, this is the formula, m a square divided by 6. Are you able to understand, ma? Clear, no? So this one you can call it as y axis, and this one you can call it as x axis, and this is the z axis. So this is the equation for a rectangular shaped lamina. This is the equation for square shaped lamina when axis is perpendicular to the plane of the lamina. A axis to find out chestunnamo adi chala important, because if axis changes, moment of inertia also changes. Center of mass depends on position. Already we studied, no? Center of mass depends on reference. Ekkada nunchi meer measure chestunnaru. Moment of inertia depends on axis of rotation. If axis of rotation changes, moment of inertia also will change. Artham avutundi kada? Seema, if this is a rod, to rotate about this axis, we will have a different moment of inertia. It is very easy to rotate. But the same rod, if I want to rotate by keeping axis here, then it is very tough to rotate. Are you able to understand? So everything depends upon axis of rotation. Fine? That's it. Okay. Now let us do some more applications on the same body. Okay, ma? Now see. So therefore, what is the lamina which we have taken? So this is a laminar body. Okay, ma? And this is our z axis. So length is L, breadth is B, and moment of inertia about z axis is m by 12 into L square plus B square. That is the formula, no, ma? M by 12 into L square plus B square, if it is a rectangularly shaped lamina. Okay. Now what I do is, on this lamina, if I place one more lamina, are you able to understand? On that lamina, I am placing one more lamina, and total mass is capital M. Now will this equation, will it change or not? If I am placing one lamina above another lamina, same type of lamina, total mass is capital M. Okay, ma? Dimensions are same. Moment of inertia, will it change or not? Equation of moment of inertia does not change, no? Why? Because distribution of mass is not changing, no? One lamina, another lamina, another lamina, if you place 100 lamina, moment of inertia does not change. Equation doesn't change. Clear, no? So on this one, if I place one more lamina, on that one I place one more lamina. Okay, ma? So continuously I am placing some 50 to 60 lamina one over the other. Now can you say this will become what kind of body? Lamina attal unnai kada mi daggara oka 100 attal place cheyandi oka dani pai okati. Formula doesn't change, no? M by 12 into L square plus B square. If you are placing 100 pads on each other, then what is that shape of the body called? Length is different, breadth is different, height is also different. Length is L, breadth is B. Now if you go on placing the lamina, height also will increase, no? Height also will be different. What is this kind of body? That is called a cuboid. What is that body called? It is called a cuboid. Cuboid is a solid body which has a different length, different breadth and different height. Are you able to understand? For example, your textbooks are there, no? Textbooks. This is a perfect example of a cuboid. Idi oka cuboid. Are you able to understand, ma? What is this paper? Paper is a lamina. If you are placing 1,000 papers, it becomes a cuboid. Are you able to understand? Breadth is different, length is different, height is also different. Which is the axis we are taking? Central axis. Are you able to understand? Moment of inertia does not change. M by 12 into L square plus B square. Are you able to understand? What about height? What about height? You need not consider height here. Okay, why? Because height is parallel to the axis, no? ఈ హైట్ యాక్సిస్కి ఎలా ఉంటుంది? ప్యారలల్గా ఉంటుంది. అండ్ ప్యారలల్ లెంత్ యూ నీడ్ నాట్ కన్సిడర్. యూ కన్సిడర్ ఓన్లీ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ లెన్స్ ఓన్లీ. టు దిస్ యాక్సిస్ దిస్ ఈస్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ నో? టు దిస్ యాక్సిస్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో పర్పెండిక్యులర్ నో? సో యూ టేక్ ఓన్లీ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ లెన్స్. ప్యారలల్ లెంత్ యూ నీడ్ నాట్ కన్సిడర్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? సో దేర్ ఫోర్ వాట్ ఐ సే హియర్ ఈజ్ ఇఫ్ లామినే ఆర్ స్టాక్డ్ one above the other, okay, ma, it becomes a cuboid, okay, ma. Your textbooks are examples of cuboids. Is it clear? So therefore, let us draw the shape of a cuboid. Approximately this is the shape of a cuboid. And which is the axis which is passing? Axis which is passing is this axis, Z axis. Are you able to understand, ma? IZ. Length is how much? Length of this cuboid is L. Breadth of this cuboid is B. And there is some height also, na, ma? This is not breadth. This is breadth. Okay, ma? And height of the cuboid is H. Understood, no? Or just if you want to draw a figure, you can draw like this also. You can draw like this also. Okay, ma? So axis is passing like this. Z axis. Understood, no, ma? So length is L, breadth is B, and height is H. Okay. So therefore, what is the formula about this axis? Let us call this one as I1. So I1 is equals to M by 12 into L square plus B square. Understood? It means which length we are taking here? Which length we are taking? We are taking those two lengths which are perpendicular to this axis. Length is perpendicular to axis, no? Breadth is also perpendicular to axis, but height is parallel to the axis. Height we should not take. Understood, no? Okay. Similarly, if I take one more lamina, let us consider this is another axis. Let us call it as moment of inertia about this one is I2. Then I2, how can I calculate? Come on, m by 12 into, so which is the axis which is parallel to this one, ma? Length is parallel, to this axis, length is parallel, ma? So you have to neglect L value. What are the remaining two values? B square and H square. So m by 12 into B square plus H square. This is how I can do the calculation. Are you able to understand? Similarly, I will take one more axis. Now, axis is like this. Okay, ma? This is the axis. And about this axis, moment of inertia, let it be I3. This axis. axis is perpendicular to the plane of the board. It is entering the board. Then to this axis, which length is parallel? Breadth is parallel, no? Breadth ila untundi. Axis also like that. Clear, no? Therefore, I3 will be m by 12 into L square plus H square. Okay, ma? That's it. That is how we can do the calculation. Understood, no? So, if you practice in the same manner, if you practice in the same method, then calculation will become very easy. Understood, no? So, therefore, what is the note point here we have to write? Okay. Take lens perpendicular to axis and neglect length parallel to axis. That's it. Understood, no? So all these calculations we have done based on which concept? We have done based on parallel axis theorem, perpendicular axis theorem, and arrangement of the bodies. That is by using symmetry conditions. Understood, no? That's it. So this is the basic concept of moment of inertia. Okay? అర్థమైంది కదమ్మా. వీటిపైన డైరెక్ట్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఒక్కోసారి వస్తాయమ్మా. ఇదంతా మీకు మైండ్లో ఉందనుకోండి, రెడీమేడ్గా డైరెక్ట్గా మీరు క్యాల్కులేషన్ చేయొచ్చు. లేదనుకోండి, ఆడేసుకోవాలి కూర్చొని, రాడ్ పైన రాడ్ పెడితే ఏమవుతుంది, 3 గంటలు దానికే సరిపోతుంది, మొత్తం మీద ఒక ప్రాబ్లం చేసి బయటకు వస్తారు. అలా కాకుండా బిఫోర్ యూ గో టు ద ఎగ్జామినేషన్ యూ షుడ్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ద మెనీ 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 టైమ్స్. అండర్స్టూడ్ నో? థియరీ చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్. జనరల్గా స్టూడెంట్స్ చేసే మిస్టేక్ వచ్చేసి దే స్టడీ ద థియరీ వన్ టైం అండ్ దే గో ఆన్ డూయింగ్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? ఫైనలీ దే విల్ నాట్ గెట్ సక్సీడెడ్. అర్థమవుతుంది కదా? ఫస్ట్ యూ రీడ్ ద థియరీ సచ్ దట్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద థియరీ కంప్లీట్లీ. థియరీలో నాకు తెలియని విషయం ఏమీ లేదు, డౌట్ ఏమీ లేదు, దెన్ యూ గో ఫర్ ద అప్లికేషన్. ఓకే, దెన్ యూ డూ మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్, 20, 30, 40, 60, 100, 120, 150 ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇన్ ఈచ్ చాప్టర్. ఓకేమా? దెన్ దట్ చాప్టర్ కంప్లీట్లీ కమ్స్ ఇన్ యువర్ గ్రిప్. దట్స్ అండర్స్టూడ్? దట్ ఈస్ ద మెథడ్ ఆఫ్ డూయింగ్. సో ఇన్ ఈచ్ చాప్టర్ అట్లీస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ టార్గెట్ ఆఫ్ సాల్వింగ్ 100 to 150 ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇన్ ఈచ్ చాప్టర్, ఫిజిక్స్ అండ్ కెమిస్ట్రీ. అండర్స్టూడ్? దెన్ దట్ చాప్టర్ విల్ బీ వెరీ ఈజీ ఫర్ యూ. అర్థమవుతుంది కదా? అన్ని ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చూడకుండా చేయగలిగితే ఆ చాప్టర్ మీకు ఇంకేం లేదు, ఈజీ అయిపోతుంది. ఇంకా కంటిన్యూస్గా ఎగ్జామ్స్ రాస్తూనే ఉంటారు కదా, అందులో రివైజ్ అవుతూనే ఉంటుంది టాపిక్. క్లియర్? థియరీ చదవకుండా ఉత్త ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ జోలికి పోయినారనుకోండి, అది రాదు ఇది రాదు అన్నమాట.